Ram and Lakshman in the forest. Let us read how Lord Ram and Lakshman helped Vishwamitra in completing his yagya peacefully without the interference of the Rakshasas. Let us read. One day, the famous Rishi Vishwamitra and his fellow Rishis came to meet Raja Dashrath at Ayodhya. He was received by the king with the respect due to his stature. Pleased by the ceremonious welcome, the Rishi stated his reason for his visit and said, "I have a request, O king, one that I hope you will oblige." Dashrath bowed his head and replied,
"O Rishi, your every wish is my command. Please tell me in what way I can fulfill what you want."
"I am planning to perform a yagya in my ashram, but Marich and Subahu are not allowing me to proceed with my plan. They put out my yagya fire. They throw rocks at me and others. They spoil the ashram and in every possible way they keep disturbing my tapas. Please send your eldest son Ram to fight these demons."
Upon hearing this, Dashrath was shell-shocked. He was thrown into a dilemma. He had made a promise to Vishwamitra without thinking. Ram was still a child of 15. He could not possibly be sent to fight demons, but there was no easy way to back out of the promise. Still, Dashrath made an attempt.
"But, O great Rishi, Ram is only 15 years old. These two demons will kill him,"
said Dashrath imploringly while bowing at Vishwamitra's feet.
"Please allow me to fight the demons and defend your ashram with my army."
Rishi Vishwamitra was renowned for his fierce temper. On hearing this, his eyes became red and he was consumed with rage.
"You have promised, Dashrath. Are you going back on your word?"
shouted Vishwamitra. Vashishth, a renowned sage at Dashrath's court, was watching this outburst. He had no intention of allowing Vishwamitra to curse Dashrath, which he knew would follow if the Rishi was not appeased. So he stepped in and said,
"Dear king, you cannot take back on your word, but we can find a solution. Do not send Ram alone. Ask Lakshman to go with Ram. Together, they will be a force to reckon with. They will accompany great Rishi Vishwamitra, who has been gifted a secret weapon from the gods themselves. He is more than capable of protecting both of them. Or do you doubt him?"
Dashrath was left without a choice. So, with great sadness, Dashrath agreed. Ram and Lakshman paid their respects to King Dashrath and the various queens before departing. Dashrath and the queens bade them farewell with tears in their eyes. Then they bowed to Rishi Vishwamitra and left with him for the ashram. Slowly, the entourage walked through the streets of Ayodhya towards the forest. The young princes carried a bow each in their hands. They had a quiver full of arrows tied on their backs. Their swords were hanging on their waists. They were warriors going on a quest. This required a farewell fit for warriors, and the people of Ayodhya gave them one. The streets were packed with people. Flowers were laid at the feet of the princes. Conches were blown. The first night, they camped by the Saryu River that flowed between Ayodhya and Vishwamitra's ashram. There, they learned two magic spells, Bala and Atibala, from the sage. These spells were designed to protect them from danger and renew them with energy. Next morning, the group entered the forest, which was a dense one, filled with animals and birds. But there were no humans. Lakshman and Ram noticed the lack of people in the forest and inquired about it. Vishwamitra answered,
"Once upon a time,
Dandak forest was filled with people. But then the demon Taraka and her sons Marich and Subahu came to live here. They started attacking people who soon had to leave the forest to escape their atrocities. But couldn't the people have fought the demons? Asked Lakshman. Well, you have not seen Taraka. She is a giant with the strength of 10 elephants. She is undefeatable. She is very angry with us because we have not left the forest. She hates rishis like me, and that is why she is wreaking havoc to force me out of the forest as well. Why does she hate rishis? They are respected by everyone. Taraka was not always a demon. Once upon a time, long ago, she was a beautiful married woman. One day, her husband annoyed the great rishi Agastya. The rishi, in his anger, cursed him, upon which he died. Taraka could not bear the news of her husband's death, so she attacked Agastya. But Agastya survived and in turn cursed Taraka to become a demon. Ram, you must kill her for the good of the people. O great saint, please forgive me. Taraka is a woman and I am a warrior, said Ram. I cannot lift my weapon against a woman. But you must not look at Taraka as a woman. She is an evil demon and she is harming other human beings. This cannot be allowed. You must punish her. Not punishing her will be injustice. Ram thought about this for some time, and then he picked up his bow and twanged it. The resulting noise echoed through the forest. All the animals panicked and started running helter-skelter. Taraka also heard the noise and recognized it as a challenge. She was enraged. She rushed towards the noise. On reaching the area, she picked up stones, uprooted trees, and started hurling them at Ram and Lakshman. Both Ram and Lakshman started shooting arrows at Taraka. These arrows did not affect Taraka much. She kept on coming after the brothers. Taraka was a demon who gained strength at nightfall. The brothers were running out of time. With this in mind, Ram took aim at Taraka and the arrow pierced her chest. She fell to the ground with a loud thud. This deed was witnessed by the gods themselves. They showered flowers on them from heaven. Vishwamitra was very happy. He blessed both the princes. Vishwamitra was assured about Ram's valor. He decided to share the weapons that the gods had gifted him. The weapons of the gods were called astras. It was not so much a weapon as it was a powerful mantra. These astras granted special powers to the weapons like fire, ice, wind, etc. He trained both Ram and Lakshman on how to use the astras. He taught them the method of arming the weapons as well as calling them back. At long last, they reached Vishwamitra's ashram. The students at the ashram gave Ram and Lakshman a hero's welcome. A thatched hut was set aside for their stay. The yagya planned by Vishwamitra was a sacred yagya. It required 7 days and 7 nights for its completion. Vishwamitra knew that Marich and Subahu would not rest without taking revenge. They were definitely going to attack during the yagya. Therefore, he asked Ram and Lakshman to guard the yagya. The preparations for the yagya were completed. The fire was lit. The rishis started chanting mantras and performing the yagya. Everything went well for 5 days. On the 6th day, Marich and Subahu attacked the ashram with an army of demons. The earth shook from their passing. Ram armed his arrow with Manav Astra and attacked Marich. Marich was flung into the ocean thousands of miles away. Then Ram armed his arrow with Agni Astra. He attacked Subahu with it. Subahu was killed on the spot. This did not stop the army. The fighting continued. Thousands of demons were killed by Ram and Lakshman. The rest fled away. When morning came, the yagya was completed. Vishwamitra praised Ram and Lakshman for their bravery. Peace once again reigned in Dandak forest. With time, people started returning to the forest. The princes had fulfilled the promise made by the king of defending the ashram and restoring peace.